We've defined what a vector space is. So it's time to now talk about vector spaces associated with matrices. So I'm going to work an example into today's video. We're going to consider a matrix A, which has 3 rows and 5 columns, so a 3x5 matrix. And we can do the calculation to find the reduced row echelon form of A. Remember that we're trying to find pivot columns where we have a 1 in the column and zeros everywhere else through the process of Gaussian elimination, where we eliminate both above and below the pivots. So I don't want to repeat that algebra here for this matrix. You can go home and check this yourself. But if you do the Gaussian elimination steps on A, this is what you get for the reduced row echelon form. Okay, so that will be our example. So what is the null space of a matrix? So the null space of a matrix A, I'll write that as null A, is a vector space of all column vectors x such that, st, such that ax equals 0. Okay? Here, for this example, x then will be a column vector, will have to have 5 rows and 1 column, right? So here, the null space of A is a subspace of all 5x1 matrices. Okay? You might ask, why is the null space a vector space? Well, if you have 2 vectors in the null space, if you multiply them by constants and add them, do you still get a vector in the null space? The answer here will be yes. I can write that down, but it's maybe kind of clear. So if you have A times the sum of 2 vectors, it's the same thing as A times the first vector plus A times the second vector. And if both vectors are in the null space, then you get 0. Okay? So the null space of the matrix A is a vector space. And here for this matrix, then it will be a subspace of all 5x1 column vectors. So what we would like to do then, if we want to find the null space of this matrix, what we really want to do is find a basis for the null space. Okay? And then the basis of the null space can span the null space, and it will give us, also give us the dimension of the null space. So we need to find the vectors x such that ax equals 0. We'll work with the reduced row echelon form of A. So this matrix then times the column vector x1 through x5 equals 0 is the same equation as ax equals 0. So if we work with the reduced row echelon form, we can write down the equations for x in the null space. So we get x1. So imagine there's a column vector here with x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. So we get 1 times x1. So we get x1. And then I'm going to throw all the other terms onto the right-hand side. So we get, it would be x1 minus 2x2. So I'm going to put the minus 2x2 onto the right-hand side. So it becomes 2x2 plus 0. Then the right-hand side will be 1, 2, 3 plus x4 minus 3x5. Okay? So that would be the first equation in ax equals 0 using the reduced row echelon form of A. So RREF of A, x equals 0. The first line here is this equation. The second line here gives us x1, x2, x3. And then we throw the other two terms on the right-hand side. So we'll have a 2 minus 2 x4 plus 2 x5. Okay? So those are the two equations we get from the reduced row echelon form of A. Okay, so this tells us what x1 and x3 have to be in relationship to x2, x4, and x5. So if we're looking for x in the null space, we have then that x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. If this is in the null space, this has to be equal to the first x1 has to be 2x2 plus x4 minus 3x5. x2 can be anything. x3 has to be minus 2x4 plus 2x5. x4 can be anything. And x5 can be anything, okay? Continuing, we can then factor out x2, and we can then write this as x2 times a vector. The vector here would be 2, 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so that takes care of x2. X3 is not here. x4, we can factor out in x4. And then we have the first row then has a 1. The second row has no x4, so has a 0. The third row has a minus 2x4. The fourth row has a 1x4. The fifth row has no x4, so we get a 0. And then the last one is x5. So we have an x5. And then we have a minus 3 in the first row, minus 3x5, a 0 in the second row, a 2 in the third row. There's an x5 here, a 2. No x5 in the fourth, and 1x5 in the fifth row. Okay? So from this reduced row echelon form of A, what I was able to do is to write the find the null space vectors that have to satisfy x1 equals this, x3 equals this. So then I wrote down the general null space vector, substituting for x1 and x3, and then splitting it up into three pieces, okay? So that means the null space is a linear combination of these three vectors. These three vectors are linearly independent. So these three vectors form a basis for the null space. Okay? So what we did was to find the basis for the null space given by these three vectors, okay? Can we say something else here? These are the pivot columns in the reduced row echelon form. We have a pivot column here, and we have a pivot column here, okay? So we have two pivot columns and three non-pivot columns. There are variables associated with the pivot columns. That's the variable associated with the first pivot column is x1, and the variable associated with the third column, which is a pivot column, is x3. So what we say, the variables associated with the pivot columns, here it's x1 and x3. These are called basic variables. And the variables associated with the non-pivot columns, which is here it's x2, 1, 2, 3, 4, x4, and x5, are called free variables. Okay? The reason is because for the variables associated with the pivot columns, you can eliminate them in these equations. And then when you substitute that into the general form for the null vector, then you have left the x2, x4, x5 that can be anything to create a null vector. So that's why they're called free variables. Okay. So let me summarize what I did here. We're looking for the null space of this matrix A. This matrix has 3 rows and 5 columns. To find the null space, you have to find the reduced row echelon form of A. I didn't do that here, but we've done that in previous videos, so you can do that yourself. Then the definition of the null space is all vectors x such that Ax equals 0. So we want to find the null space, so we take reduced row echelon form of A times x equals 0. That allows us to solve for x1 and x3 associated with the pivot columns of reduced row echelon form A. We can substitute in for x1 and x3 and then split it up where we have these free variables times column matrices, x2, x4, and x5. And these column matrices then form a basis for the null space. So the span of these 3 vectors give us the null space. In the next video, I'll show you an application. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.